example of what he would do. He was always looking for me, and I knew him. So the church was about 70 guys. I was always in the back of the parish, and they came for instruction. And he came in, and his two buddies are already just gay, Henson. And now he's looking around all over the room, maybe for 5 or 10 seconds. And then he spots me. He says, "You, Zamperini, you come to attention last." Well, that was a put-on. He knew he didn't see me. After about 5 or 10 seconds, he sees me. It was just an excuse to punish me. So he called me up in a big web belt, just put around his waist, about 4 inches wide, about an inch or half inch thick, with about a pound and a half buckle on the end, steel buckle. And he made me stand in the tent, and they get me across the temple. And I don't go down easy before I hit the deck. And man, I was stunned, and I started to shake my head, and the brothers worked out. Then he takes a piece of photo tissue and hands it to me and says, "Oh, I'm sorry. I'm going to take you so bad after all, Joy." I put the paper on my temple and got up. I took the paper off to see how much blood there was. He hit me again in the same spot. And so this time I couldn't get up. But that was the word, and so I'm lucky to be alive going through about 2 years with him, a year and a half.
The bird was a sadistic psychopath. We assume the Empire knew that because they moved both of them to another camp, and there were 100 POW camps on the island, and the odds of them meeting up a second time were so remote that we assumed there had to be some mission behind it. And the bird, he knew the war was over about a week before anybody else did, and he skedaddled, and that's how he got away.
Well, they take the bird into the coop.